What is best? According to Nabil Hamdi, in his book Small Change, best means most excellent, most suitable, most desirable, something which surpasses all others. It is an ultimate state beyond which there can be little improvement, at least for now. In art, in particular, sculpture, the best works are often considered to be those made centuries ago by the great masters of art. But is this always the case? Sculpture has been around for centuries. The earliest sculptures were used to document the world the sculptors lived in. Over time, the definition and concepts of sculpture have grown, and perhaps the fact that it is ever-changing is what makes this style of art so popular. Michelangelo, one of the most famous artists ever, lived centuries ago, in the 14th and 1500s. In 1501, at the age of 26, he was commissioned by a prosperous business to sculpt a statue of David, a biblical hero. The 15.17-meter marble figure was depicted as strong and brave, encouraging the character of a diligent Renaissance man. At the time of its creation, Florence was surrounded by strong armies, so the piece had some definite political references. The work had also been made in a very classical style, like that used by the Greeks and Romans. It portrays David as a youth, handsome and strong, and like many of the Greek heroes, he is a standing heroic male. David is a very detailed work, his veins and tendons showing clearly. Born in about 1386, Donatello was an Italian artist, considered to be one of the greatest of all Renaissance sculptors. He began working as a goldsmith, and many of the things he'd become skilled at helped him later on when he began his art. From 1411 to 1413, he created a piece called St. Mark. The work was very classical, much like Michelangelo's David. St. Mark is a very detailed and realistic piece. Although Donatello was well known for his way of conveying expressions on his figures, many of his sculptures, including St. Mark, had no meaning apart from the emotion portrayed through the expression of his subjects. The main inspiration from his work came simply from reality and other sculptures. Augusto Dahn is one of the most famous artists ever. Born in 1840, he was a modern artist from Paris, France. Rodin was very nearsighted from a young age, but that clearly did not prevent him from creating his works. The remarkable artist nearly became a monk after the death of his sister, but was encouraged to carry out his passion, and in 1886 he produced what was to be undoubtedly his most famous artwork ever. The Kiss was originally made as part of Rodin's Gates of Hell, but astounded the world in its own right. In creating this work, Rodin stated, "The sculptor must learn to reproduce the surface, which means all that vibrates on the surface, soul, love, passion, life." The Kiss depicts a couple kissing, inspired by a love affair in the book, Dante's Inferno. Two Women is a work by Ron Meek, a modern artist. Born in Australia in 1958, the London-based artist is renowned for his hyper-realistic works. Meek worked in television and film before working in making models for photography in the advertising industry. He eventually concluded that photography couldn't capture an object in reality and turned to sculpture and fine art. After one of his works was seen by a collector in the studio of Meek's mother-in-law, his works became more and more well-known. The work Two Women was made in 2005, and it is an artwork of two miniature elderly women with gossiping and conspiring looks on their faces. The audience is vital to the presence of this artwork, as the proportion greatly affects the feelings conveyed through the art, as they tower over the works. Mute captures humans in their weakest moments and makes the audience ponder their own reality as they observe such realistic works that are so absurdly out of proportion with their own figures. Dardang Kristanto was born in Indonesia in 1957. Kristanto had a traumatizing childhood during which his father was taken away and killed. Much of his art reflects his pain towards the persecution of people in Indonesia, and he uses it to speak out in a way that one normally wouldn't be able to. His work, They Give Evidence, is such a piece, and it depicts 16 male and female figures carrying the bodies of innocent victims. The somberness of the work is a powerful reflection of the united anguish of such inhumane acts. Through the openness to be a part of the work, and through the name itself, the audience are confronted that through the art, they themselves are forever witnesses to the despicable acts the scene portrays. Born in 1901 in Switzerland, Alberto Giacometti grew up in a home where his father was an artist, and from an early age he would paint, draw and sculpt. His family supported him enormously, and after high school he decided he would dedicate his life to art. Giacometti went through many phases of art before he began creating art he truly loved. He quickly became famous worldwide. One of the artists he produced during this years of fame was the piece Grande Femme de Brut II. This piece was made in an elongated fashion and was extremely thin, with a texture that was corroded and scarred looking. The work displayed a compelling message of the fragility and emptiness of human life. The best art is more than an image. It causes you to feel emotion and changes you. This is what makes modern sculptures better than those made centuries ago. They have a personality that the older ones lack. Although the works are made with incredible skill on behalf of the artist, skill in art is no longer as important as it once was. In the modern world, it is easy with the tools that we now have to create skillful pieces. It is really meaning that is valued most in art, because only the best artists can make their audience feel and understand emotion through a work.